So let's start testing on Laravel application. And what we need, a Laravel app, and I will say testing Laravel, simple one, and it will create the new app. And new app is downloaded successfully. So let's open this with our VS Code. So let's start testing on Laravel application. And with that, I'm your host Sarthak, and welcome to this channel called BitFumes. And if you have not subscribed, go and subscribe to this channel for Laravel and web development related things. And don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you will get the notification. So let's see what we are getting on this Laravel application related to testing. So Laravel is so smart that it will give you PHP unit as a testing tool out of the box. So for that, you can go to composer.json file, and here you can see a dev dependencies has PHP unit, which we already know we want to install it, but because we are using Laravel, we don't have to install it. Apart from that, if you have watched the previous episode of getting started with PHP unit, you have probably seen that we have created this PHP unit.xml, which is again already given by Laravel. And apart from that, we need a test folder where we will put all our tests, and again same thing given by Laravel, but it has two folders. One is feature, other is unit, and two more files. So let's talk about feature first, because we have already talked about unit testing, but what is feature and why it is having a separate folder? So the difference between feature test and unit test, you can see it just saying assert true, and here it's saying go to this get, that means the base URL, and then assert status 200. What's the difference here? So if you are not getting that, let me tell you. As we know, the unit test is for testing the smallest functions of your code, but the feature test will give you all the way from the user perspective. That means you will test the flow of your application from this feature test. So it's saying whenever user go to the base URL, it must have the status code of 200, and that's exactly the flow of any application. Whenever you go to the base URL, you will get the page, and that means you are getting the 200 response. So what if I run this test? So we know we have installed the extension called Better PHP here, and because of that we can just run any test just by pressing command R on Mac or control R on Windows. So you can see as I pressed command R, it just running that test, and you can see the test name is feature and example test.php, and this test is successful. But what if I say get and I will say about, save this file, run this test. It says the test fails. Why? You know, it says the test you are testing expect 200 but received 404, and that is why this test is failing. So let's just pass this test. Why this is failing? We know that there is 404, that means there is no route called about. What if we create the route? So go to web.php, and again on the VS Code you need to press command P and search for any file. Don't try to use your mouse. Okay, so web.php, and here a simple route is a get request having about and giving a closer here, close this line, and returning simple word about. Looking nice. So what if I run? I'm pretty sure this test will pass, which is here, and this exactly feature test. So what if I do something like this? We want to know whether this about is having this return part or not, because if I comment this out and run the previous test, it is still passing, but we are not returning anything. What if I want to check? So let's create another test for that. So public function about route return something. Okay, so this is the test we are going to create, and don't forget to give the doc box if you are not giving test prefix here like this. Okay, so this means now we can simply say, just copy paste all these things and like this, which is like this, and now we want to say if there is something on the response or not. But what if I die and dump response? Let's comment this out, run this test, and you know, for running this particular test, I clicked here on this test and pressed Ctrl R. If I click here, press Ctrl R, it run this test, not this one. So let's click here, run this test, and yeah, we have die dump. And now let's do one more thing. And here, because we are getting something on the response, we can comment that, and now I will check whether we have about or not. So assert C about, run this test, and yes, you can see it passes. And if I change something about page and go run this test, it is still saying passes because this include this about. But if I remove this about and run the test, it fails. Yeah, you know, it fails. And that's exactly the feature test is about. So this is good, but how I know there is assert C asserting system on the Laravel? So simple, you need to go to Laravel documentation, and here on the documentation you will find this testing part and HTTP tests. Just go to available assertions and you will see lots and lots of assertions. So this is for about we have created. But you know, one more thing, yeah, we can go to base URL. Yeah, we know this passes because if it is responding with 200, but we can simply say assert C and Laravel because we have this assert C, and we know this particular one. So let me just run the server and let's open it here. Yes, we can see we have the Laravel on the base page or base URL, and yes, we are getting that. Okay, go to the base URL and see Laravel. If there is a Laravel, this test passes. Run, passes, super cool. If I say Sarthak, does that is there? No, it says okay, Sarthak is not present. But what if I want to say, you can see we have Laravel, then we have documentation. So there is one more cool thing, see in order. So let's use that C in order. And what order we need? First thing first, we need Laravel, and obviously here inside this we need to give an array, and then it's like documentation. Okay, so let's run this test, and yeah, this test passes. What if I change the order? So this is here and this is here. Save this, run the test, and boom, it fails, and this means our test is passing. So you can go to this documentation, check out all these assertions. There are a bunch of assertions, and feel free to experiment with all these things, and this will enhance your testing knowledge. And we will do some more cool stuff in the next episode. But before that, if you have not subscribed to this channel, please go and subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon to get the instant notification. Follow Bitfumes on Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn, and don't forget to share these videos with your developer friends. So we will meet in the next episode. Till then, goodbye.